Kramer, Tournament Director of the Farmers Classic. This is the 85th staging of the tournament. Can you tell us a little about the tournament history?
Well, it began obviously in 1927. And the motivation for holding the championships was initially to help bring the Olympic Games to Los Angeles. Obviously, the Tennis Association was promoting tournaments of all sizes, and they had the Southern California Championships. So they wanted to stage a very large international event that would bring people from around the world and show the International Olympic Committee that they could put on a first-class championships. They held it in 1927. Bill Tilden won it, and it's been going on ever since. And I guess it became so popular and accepted that the tradition was able to continue.
And you've pretty much grown up around this tournament. You started off as a ball boy, and you've progressed to tournament director. What's your first memory of this tournament?
Gosh, probably as a ball boy, at an early age, maybe around 10 years old. Players like Roy Emerson and Barry McKay and Butch Buchholz, I was probably 9, 10, 11 at the time. Obviously working for the Tennis Association, fabulous guy who was really in charge of everything, Mr. Perry Two Jones. And apparently I was either named after Mr. Jones, my middle name is Perry, or I'll tell the alternative story of Fred Perry, who won this championship 3 times in a row. So began as a ball kid, moved up through the ranks, but over those years, there's so many champions, there's so many wonderful players through that era, that it was all Australians in the 60s with Laver and Newcomb and others, and then it became a nice American run, Ash and Connor, Stan Smith and others, and then open tennis came along about that same time, and it was exciting because in the first year of open tennis in 1968, there was only one other event in America that was open to professionals and amateurs, which was the U.S. Championships. But so many special moments. I think the ones that resonate the most are the people I've known the longest. So as I grew up with some of those great Australians, Ken Rosewall, Rod Laver, Lou Hode, it became later on players that came through some of our developmental programs, people who played junior tennis. And in more recent years, and it was always men and women in those days, so I can remember Billie Jean King winning the tournament, et cetera, et cetera. We had Maria Bueno playing, and obviously Rosie DeSalles and many others. But when we moved the event from the Los Angeles Tennis Club to UCLA, we only had room for 2 courts. And so it was just about the time that the women were starting their separate tour. And we came to the campus for the first time in 1975. And it was a men-only event from there. So many special moments before 1975 and leading up to now, where it's in our 85th year.
And what do you think sets this tournament apart from the others?
You know, I think, you know, now we're the only tournament on the West Coast in the swing. We used to always be back-to-back with San Francisco. Barry McKay ran a tournament that is now in San Jose. And following that, there was a third event that was held in Hawaii over on Maui. But I think it's a West Coast atmosphere. We obviously have slightly cooler weather during this time of year. For the majority of the tournament's history, it was held in September. And then we were able to, with the new ATP Tour, starting in 1990, we were able to get a summer date where we actually, for this location on the UCLA campus and our great Strauss Stadium here, we were able to move from the tennis club and come to UCLA. But without a date out of the school, general session, there's no parking available, so we needed a summer date. We were able to do that, and this great stadium has been hosting the event now since 1984, where it also held the Olympic Games. So over to the side, you'll see a plaque at our flagpoles that honored 2 pretty good players, Steffi Graf and Stefan Edberg.
And an American has won the last 2 editions of the tournament. Do you think that top seed Marty Fish extend that streak this week?
Marty seems like he's playing the best of all the players. Just following the players this year, Marty's in such tremendous shape. He's so fit that he has to be the favorite. Clearly, Juan Martín del Potro, another champion of the tournament, is coming on strong. But I think as the top seed in current form, Marty is clearly the favorite.